Well, in between your chocolate chip cookies and fried pickles, be sure to check out some of the gardens here on the fairgrounds.
The interesting thing is some of them are owned and maintained by the state fair, and some of them are adopted, called adopt-a-gardens. Well, the first one you should check out is the Liberty Bell.
The oldest garden here at the Minnesota State Fair. A lot of succulents going on in this one.
Originally constructed in 1921, the State Fair Liberty Bell has succulents, moss rose, hens and chicks, and underneath it's accompanied by a mix of petunias and really a great use of celery plants and alyssum.
You can find this Liberty Bell garden just outside the Horticulture Building near the corner of Cosgrove and Judson.
Oh, I found a great place to sit while maybe you're waiting for somebody that goes to the bathroom more than normal. That'd be you.
That'd be me. Hey, this is one of the adopt-a-gardens at the Minnesota State Fair. This one by Anoka Technical College. They bring all the plants, they design it, they take care of it.
They maintain it. And it's right here in the new West End Market area. And it's also right across from Lulu's Public House. So you could have a beer while you're waiting, too.
Double duty.
There you go. If you're a fan of native plants like someone I know,
you can see what late summer Minnesota color looks like in the DNR Gardens,
which is located right across the street from
the Care Barn. Come see us and check out all the gardens at the Minnesota State Fair.
Well, we have a list of all the gardens with a map of where you can find them at care11.com.
And tomorrow morning, the morning show will have some of those maps for the audience. Sitting next to me is